Hey friends, welcome back. And welcome back to my series on how to study anything. In this video, I'm going to be giving you a comprehensive guide on how to study physics. Not only are we going to be looking at how to study physics, we're going to be looking at how to study it fast and effectively, so you waste no time on it. I'm going to show you my step-by-step process for studying physics. So let's get started. First, let me present to you my credentials. I studied physics in 10th and 12th grade. During IGCSE and IB respectively. In IGCSE, I got an A star, and in IB, I got a 7/7. And in IB, I also did physics at higher level, which means that I had to study it in greater depth and spend a far greater amount of time on it than I would ever have on a regular basis. Alright, so let's do first things first. And the first thing you must realize when you're about to start studying physics is you need to see the reality. You need to see physics for what it really is, which is a branch of applied mathematics, essentially. As one of my physics teachers explained it to me, physics is like marrying Priyanka Chopra. Nick Jonas marries Priyanka Chopra, and she's very beautiful and she looks great and all of that stuff. Yet, when Nick Jonas marries Priyanka Chopra, he also gets all the emotional baggage that she's carrying around. Personally, I don't really know anything about this Bollywood, Hollywood, like celebrity gossip. Yet I hope you get the idea. Physics isn't as glamorous as it looks like. And it comes with a lot of nonsense. A lot of just sheer math and manipulation. So the first thing to do is to stop watching all those popular science videos that you see on YouTube and all those movies and all. Because physics isn't really like that. When you're down in the trenches, it doesn't look like that at all. It's not glamorous, it's not sexy, it's not cool. So after you've gotten this misconception out of your mind, I highly recommend you pause this video right now and you watch my video on the basics of studying. So you have a solid foundation. Go ahead, I'll wait. But make sure you watch that video before you come back here. So once you've watched my video on the fundamentals of effective studying, the first thing to do is to establish some good habits, like some physics hygiene, if you will. These are not rules, these are not directives, you know, you don't have to do these. And you may find that a lot of the top scoring people in your physics class don't do any of these things. As a matter of fact, the physics whiz in my class used to study on his bed. But anyway, one of the best practices you can do is embrace the mad scientist paradigm. Now, what does that mean? Imagine some mad scientist like Jimmy Neutron. What you do when you first see the physics problem, especially if it's a complicated one, is you imagine in your mind how you're going to approach it, how you're going to plan it out. You're effectively planning out the physics problem. You do it in English, you do it in history, don't you? Why don't you just do it over here as well? It is so much better than just randomly plugging in formulas and values and wasting time and eventually not even getting anything. So the first thing to do is plan it out in your head. The other thing I strongly recommend to you, and which might surprise you, is to use enough paper. And if you don't have enough paper, be assertive enough to ask for that damn paper. And I'm talking about shitloads of paper. Let me illustrate this with a story, right? I was once writing this mock exam back at school, like a proper exam. And there was this one 4-mark question on deriving some formula. And in that tiny amount of space, I wasn't able to get anything done, so I asked for paper, and I still couldn't finish it, so I asked for more paper, and I asked for more paper, and eventually I had written on like 3 pieces of paper, and I finally got the answer to that 4-mark question, and even the physics teacher, my physics teacher who was marking it, he was amazed. He was like, wow, Rishi, like, I didn't know what you were doing over there, but you finally got the answer, so I gave you the marks. But you see, right? Where would I have been if I didn't have that paper? When you have enough paper, you also have space to think. You also have space to make mistakes. So please learn to be assertive, learn to ask firmly but politely for that paper so you don't lose marks for the stupidest of reasons, which is you didn't have enough space. And a final good habit is, you should have a solid foundation in math. I know this is kind of obvious, but my physics teacher used to say that he actually stopped studying physics like professionally because he found that it was just too much math. There wasn't any physics and it was all just math. Now the next thing to note is, begin with the end in mind. What kind of physics exam are you up against? Is it one where you can make as many mistakes as you want, or one where you are going to be penalized for making mistakes? What kind of calculator are you permitted in the exam? Can you bring a graphic calculator, or can you only bring a basic scientific calculator? Or is it no calculator? In which case, you'll have to know some mental math for it. Also, watch out for the time pressure. Is it one of those exams where it is intentionally designed that you cannot answer all the questions in the given time? In which case, you're going to have to prioritize and focus on your strengths. Remember to also know about the things that you have access to. Do you have access to like an entire geometry set? Because that can be useful in certain physics problems. If you don't, or if you don't have any idea, then just ask. Ask the exam proctor or whoever it is in charge of your exam at school. Now finally, problems are everything in physics. Literally, just doing problems is all there is to really studying physics. So that's my number one tip, in fact. As long as you adopt good physics hygiene and you do the correct problems, then you'll be set. But what I mean by correct problems is, don't do any random problems from any random textbook. If you're studying the IBDP, right, the International Baccalaureate, then you should be doing only IB physics problems, not A levels. Trust me, I did the mistake. If you're studying A levels, then do A level problems. If you're studying CBSE, then do CBSE problems. But all the while, only focus on the most relevant kind of questions. Also need to focus on doing drill and mixed problems. Drill is when you just focus on one type of problem and keep doing it so you get comfortable with that kind of problem. For example, projectile motion, or maybe kinematics, or maybe gravitational fields, whatever it is. Whereas mixed is what you'll actually face in the exam, in which all the topics are just jumbled together. So don't forget to do mixed problems as well, because that's actually what you're going to find in the exam. They won't only test your ability to solve the problem, but also to recognize what concept you're supposed to apply. As always, start off without a time limit, because then you can really focus on doing that problem and maybe get some help at the start, but progressively add the time limit or the necessary time limit, or even below the time limit, so you're extra good at that problem, and then progress from there. Finally, you may find my step-by-step approach to solving physics problems useful. I'll link it over here. The thumbnail should appear over here, and the link will be in the descriptions and the comments below. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And what did you think? Leave a comment down below. Remember to share and subscribe. And as always, I'll catch you next time.